Radnor Actors Workshop conquered Radnor High School.
And winter sports are well underway.
Hello and welcome to the Radnor Report for the week of December 5th. I'm Charles Harper.
And I'm Madeline Chuck. We'll have those stories and more later in the show. But topping the Radnor beat this week, Radnor High School senior Dorothy Hazen is a winner of the 2011 National Council of Teachers of English Achievement Award in Writing. She joins 520 winners nationwide and just 24 in Pennsylvania. She is the only winner in Delaware County and the first Radnor High School winner since 2007. The prestigious award is based on performance in analytical, expository, and creative writing from a student's junior year, plus another submission on a controlled topic. All entries are judged by high school and college English teachers. Last year, Hazen worked extensively on her submission with her English teacher, Trevor Payne.
Yeah, Dorothy's a special young woman. At a young age, she understands the full range of behaviors required to produce great writing.
Hazen's accomplishment was recognized at the November 22nd Radnor Township School District Board of School Directors meeting. Board member Susan Michelson congratulated Hazen and her proud parents and awarded her a certificate. Payne and Radnor High School's English Department Chair Carl Rosen also attended the ceremony. Congratulations, Dorothy.
The Thursday before Thanksgiving, Radnor High School teachers and students cooked and served traditional Thanksgiving dishes to hundreds of community members at the school's 19th annual Thanksgiving dinner. Students and parents brought in and prepared turkeys, mashed potatoes, and other delicious holiday foods to create a Thanksgiving feast for the members of Mount Vernon Baptist Church, members of the Wayne Senior Center, and our own high school custodial staff. However, the tryptophan certainly didn't take its toll, as the meal was followed by musical performances by RHS students and church members, gospel songs by the church choir, and dancing. The event was also the last for Lois Wysocki, an RHS science teacher who has coordinated the dinner since its inception and is retiring at the end of the school year. Students served dinners from rolling trays as teachers and other volunteers prepared dishes in the kitchen. All leftovers were sent home with attendees. After the meal, the choir and church musicians performed, getting both students and seniors off their feet to share the dance floor. The high school has also collected items during a food drive the week before that the church members took with them to distribute to the needy in their neighborhood. We have some clips of the heartwarming event.
School's math teacher Mike McBride and the National Honor Society are participating in Gifts from the Heart. Our own Ellen Francis met up with Mr. McBride to talk more about the program.
During these festive but frantic times, people tend to get caught up in the commercialism of the holiday and forget the real meaning of the season. Thankfully, RHS students came together and realized that giving is better than receiving.
Gifts from the Heart, a 21-year endeavor started by RHS math teacher Mr. McBride, has created the opportunity for RHS students to brighten the holidays of those less fortunate.
The kids are actually in this area. Most of them are Montgomery County, Norristown, Upper Marion area. There are kids that are on caseloads, kids that are in foster care, kids that are in shelters. There's some homeless shelters and there's some abuse shelters in Norristown. And there's also some kids who have been referred to the program because they're just very impoverished and there's nothing at home. Caseworkers make suggested gifts for the kids in sizes of their clothes, and we make individual cards to hand out to the students here. Please return the gifts with the card you took attached to room 208 by Wednesday, December 14th. The gifts that Radnor students get for these students will be the only things they get during the holidays. So it's a really nice thing, and as you see with a lot of the requests, kids need clothing, kids need notebooks, kids need pencils, I mean, they need a lot of things just to get by day to day. You can get a gift card. Walmart's a good one because they can get to Walmart easily, but a gift card to a store, and we give it to a parent, and then they can feel like they're actually part of the process, so they go to Walmart, buy their child a gift, and that sort of makes them a little bit empowered.
Due to his role in the program, I asked Mr. McBride what he was giving, assuming it would be the best gift of all.
I'm giving Fs in math.
I'm Ellen Francis from RADTV, and in the spirit of giving, back to you.
Thanks, Ellen. So, Charles, what are you giving me for the holidays?
Please, Madeline, let's be professional here.
Don't go away.
We'll be right back with sports.
Asian? Sure. Let's go with that.
Theater captain reporting for duty.
We've been working hard, so we're ready to play.
Got a lot to prove.
There's a terrible
how thing. These 4 years have just been a whirlwind of emotion, and how if we come together as a team, we can end hunger and fight disease and kill the terrorists. Yeah.
It's probably the first day for the cool hitches.
I know, hair. Sunday night.
I'm Crazy Chester, and I'm down here at the RHS school store where we're slashing prices on brand new assignment books. Only $5 down and no payment until forever. Come on down, bring all your friends and ask for me, Crazy Chester, or Mrs. Schaefer. We got magnets. We got brand new pencils. We got Chevys. Just kidding, we ain't got Chevys. But we do got geometers. Only $4. I'm not sure what a geometer is, but at that price, who cares? We got license plates. Put them on your car. Put them on your truck. Put them on your grandma. Heck, they're only $15. The license plate, not your grandma. We got shorts for only $13, and we got shirts for $7. We got all that and more. So come on down to the RHS school store from 2:30 to 3 for all of your holiday shopping needs.
Welcome back to the Radnor Report. I'm Madeline Schutt.
And I'm Charles Harper. We go now to sports with Abe Fagenbaum. Abe?
Last Friday, the Radnor High School Cronum team, the DY Nasties, won the inaugural High School Cronum World Championships. To find out more about this new and exciting sport, I met with a few DY Nasty players.
I'm here with the DY Nasties, the High School World Champions of Cronum. How did this sport evolve and sort of come to be?
A guy named Bill Gibson founded in Villanova.
Yeah.
Started. I think like 7 years ago.
Started in an outdoor court. Or outdoor field, and then they moved to an indoor turf later.
And that's where we won our championship. Yeah.
So guys, what are you doing to get more people in the school to know about and become involved with Cronum?
We made a Cronum club. We're trying to get 30 kids, and then if we get 30 kids, we get a free goal and two balls.
Yeah, so right now, we just played in the fall season, and we had one Radnor team. But in the spring league, we could put out like two Radnor teams, and that would help us a lot, I think.
So how is the game of Cronum played?
Well, there's one ball, Cronum ball. It's an awesome ball. Really sticky, you know. And you have to dribble it when you're using your hands. Because there's like hand zones and then there's feet zones. And I don't know. You have to look at the field to understand that part.
Field, circle. Four goals. Any team, there's two teams. Each team can score on any of the goals, but once they get possession, they have to go to the middle of the field. So
and then once the ball goes to the middle of the field, the goalies kind of like switch out.
So it's kind of like half-court basketball
in
a way.
Yeah.
So guys, what are you doing to get more people in the school to know about and become involved with Cronum?
Me and Matt Pelton founded the club, so if any of you want to join, look for me or Matt Pelton.
Yeah.
Go to Cronum.com for sure.
I certainly will. The Cronum Club is currently looking for more participants. Please contact Matt Pelton, our very own Ellen Francis' boyfriend, if you have any questions. And now a preview of the student, faculty, and Powderpuff football games from this year's LM Week DVD.
The juniors cannot play football. The seniors, we're a unit. We've been practicing hours and hours every single day for the last 4 months.
Juniors, 33 to 1, 7, 34-7.
Seniors are cheating a little.
Game time.
Ben, what's your outlook on tonight's game?
Well, tonight, I think we got a lot of studs. We got Drew Mackin, we got Pat Corelli, we got Kevin Zhao. He has really nice arms.
Gotta watch him.
And I'll tell you what, Dewey, he's translucent. I can see right through that kid.
So I'm here with the new head softball coach. Coach, do you think your skills in softball are gonna be able to carry over onto the gridiron?
I don't know. In the past, I've dropped a couple balls. I think without having a glove, that hinders me from catching more.
I'm here with Sofiane Hadjar. Sofiane, you guys are down 2-0 right now. Why is that?
It's been a tough game. We got some good plays, but overall, just unlucky, I feel, but we'll come back.
Nice in.
We got little star quarterback right there. But we'll come back. We got it.
Have you just been cheating?
Oh, it's just they're the dirtiest players here.
They're mid.
So that's it for this week's sports. I'm Abe Feigenbaum. Back to you.
Thanks, Abe. So, Charles, did you get to see me score a touchdown at the game?
Actually, it was in attendance with my pink pom-poms and miniskirt.
Don't go away.
We'll be right back.
Breakfast with Santa, take one.
Susie on set.
And action.
Hi, my name's Little Susie,
And, well, every morning I wake up and I have my Cocoa Puffs for breakfast. But today's special because I'm having breakfast with Santa.
Hey, kids.
Santa, for breakfast, I just wanted to tell you, I want an Easy Bake Oven, I want a Hannah Montana doll, I want... What is this? You're not the real Santa!
Cut!
Mommy!
Breakfast with Santa, take two.
Action.
Kid, listen, times are tough. I gotta do what to get by.
Fine. Come to Radnor Middle School and have breakfast with the real Santa.
What are you doing there?
Oh, hi, John. I'm making a gingerbread house for the gingerbread house contest.
The one for breakfast with Santa?
Yeah, the one at the Radnor Middle School.
Yeah, the one December 10th.
Yeah, entries are due at 9 o'clock. You know what this means, don't you?
That only means one thing.
Gingerbread house off!
Gumdrops? The contest is K through 8th grade. You're on the naughty list. You, Cole, you're getting Cole. Naughty list, all of you.
Looks like we're just gonna have to eat it.
Welcome back to the Radnor Report. On Wednesday, December 7th, Radnor High School hosted a program on cyberbullying and internet safety sponsored by REACH, Radnor Encouraging Awareness, Communication, and Hope for Our Community, Alliance for Safe Kids, and the Radnor Township Board of Health in the school's auditorium. Joseph Lesniak, an assistant district attorney for Delaware County, spoke at the event. The event provided students with information about being safe online, sexting, social networking, and cyberbullying. This same program was offered to parents Wednesday night in the RHS auditorium and taught parents how to help protect their children from the dangers of the internet.
The Radnor Township School District Board of Directors held their reorganization meeting on December 6th. Patricia Booker, Lisa Barowski, Kimberly Doherty, Charles Madden, and Eric Zajac were sworn in for 4 year terms, and Brucey Rappaport was elected president, and Robert Armstrong was elected as vice president.
Before the Thanksgiving break, the Radnor Actors Workshop performed She Stoops to Conquer by Oliver Goldsmith in the RHS Black Box Theater to rave reviews. This play was full of mistaken identity and the romance of several sets of lovers. Many pranks ensued from the character of Tony Lumpkin, and many deceptions occurred in trying to secure Miss Neville's fortune and jewels. Young Mr. Marlowe only felt at ease with girls of the lower sort, and whether he could summon the courage to court Kate Hardcastle was all part of this delightful plot. This 18th century comedy starred Hannah Welsh, Megan Doherty, Kim Sass, Aubrey Carey, Philip Morbido, Blake Thompson, Antonio Lopez, Eugene Kim, Drew Vollmer, along with Rachel Silverman, Marissa Ellis, Laura Bryan, Jamie Weedman, Jack Chuang, and Devin Bryan. The stage manager was Aaron Haddon. Congratulations to director Marianne Morgan and her entire cast and crew for a job well done. Well, that about wraps it up for this week's edition of the Radnor Report. I'm Madeline Schutt.
And I'm Charles Harper. From all of us here, have a great weekend and even better week. See you next time.